My name is Stephanie, and welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, this year I will be a first-year teacher teaching at an international school in Bangkok, Thailand. Today I'm going to talk about my student teaching experience as an elementary education major. I know student teaching can vary by school and state, so I kind of want to go over the process of my program at my university and my personal experience in student teaching. I attended the University of Central Florida, and at UCF there are two semesters of student teaching. They are placed at the last two semesters of your program, but throughout your program you are completing a certain amount of service learning hours attached to certain classes, and you are going into different classrooms and observing and just kind of getting a feel of the classroom itself. There is no direct instruction while you are completing these service hours. Most of my courses were methods courses, so focus on the learning of teaching certain content areas such as math, reading, science, social studies, so forth. I do remember at the beginning of my program at UCF that I had to sign a contract stating that I would complete and pass the general knowledge test exam within the first three semesters of my program. If you do not complete all subtests of the general knowledge test exam, you are not able to continue to take classes until you do. Luckily, I was able to pass all subtests prior to that final contract. Talk about pressure. After the general knowledge test, you have two other Florida state exams that you must complete before you can apply for student teaching. You have the professional teaching exam as well as the subject area exam. I do want to say, as a student, please know your catalog and don't always take your advisor's word for it when it comes to classes you need. I ended up taking two, almost three extra courses than I needed to because my advisor was looking in the wrong catalog year, and I know I wasn't the only one that happened to. So know your catalog and do your research because you don't want to take extra courses you don't need and you don't want to spend the extra money you don't have to. Okay, so now you're in your last two semesters of the program. You have internship one and you have internship two. I'll first talk about internship one and then I'll go on to internship two. Internship one is 2 days a week and you are required to take three courses along with it. My internship one started in the fall and it was Mondays and Tuesdays and it was from 8 to 3:30 p.m. And along with that, I took a math class, a reading class, and an exceptional student class. Math and reading were face-to-face classes that I took at night on Wednesdays and Thursdays from 6 to 9 p.m. and my exceptional student class was an online class. These are the times that I picked because it worked best for me, but I do know that some students took it at main campus or other locations during the day, during the evening. It just depends on what you need personally. In your first student teaching semester, you have two placements, but they are at the same school. Six of those weeks are in an intermediate class, and the other 6 weeks are in a primary class. My placements were in a fifth grade class, and then I was in a first grade class. So the first 6 weeks I spent in fifth grade, and then the last 6 weeks I spent in first grade. Within those placements, you have a total of six observations that you will complete. The first three are in your first placement, and the last three are in your second placement. Two of those observations are completed by your mentor teacher, and then one is completed by your UCF coordinator. And then again, in your second placement, two of those observations are completed by your mentor teacher, and then one of them is completed by your UCF coordinator. During your first semester of student teaching, you are required to complete a case study with one of the students in one of your placements. The case study is done through reading class and is completed throughout the semester and is broken up into three different parts. So even when you switch your placement, you are working with that same student that you started the case study with until the end of the semester. Basically, with the case study, what you are doing is completing a reading inventory as well as an interest inventory. And then with the data from the reading inventory and the interest inventory, you are finding where the student's needs are and then using the interests of the student to create different interventions to work with the student and really engage them during this process. Throughout the semester, you are working with the student on the interventions you made from their interests and their needs for at least 15 hours. And then at the end of the semester, what you do is complete another reading inventory. Then you graph your findings from the first inventory to the second inventory. You will then write a report on the graphs, on what worked, what didn't work, what you would do differently if you had more time with the student, and just analyze all the data and results of what happened throughout the semester. I was extremely stressed at the beginning of the case study, but once I got into it, it was a lot easier than I thought, and I learned a lot from that process. Now I'm gonna talk about my personal student teaching experience. Now I want you to know that not every student teaching experience is the same, and sometimes we're placed with a teacher that we might not mesh well with, and that's okay. If you have a good experience or a bad experience, regardless of the experience, learn as much as you can regardless of the situation. If you don't like what you see, then jot that down and just make note that you don't want to be like that in your class. I have to be honest, my first placement was pretty challenging. Our teaching styles are completely different and we didn't really mesh very well, and that's just how it was. I took every day as an opportunity to grow with the good or the bad. And all I could hope was that I was also helping my mentor teacher grow as well. But who knows? In that placement, I never felt like I could do my own thing as a teacher. I felt like she couldn't let go of control even when I was the one instructing the class, which was frustrating, but I did what I had to do and I got through it. As an intern, sometimes you might feel like you can't speak up and you just kind of have to ride it out, which is how it is sometimes. But just make note of the things that you don't like and recognize that is something that you don't want to do yourself when you're in the classroom. But in the end, regardless of my relationship with that mentor teacher, I knew I was there for those students and I was there to grow as an educator, and that is what I did. You are not required as an intern to be best buddies with your mentor teacher, nor do we have to like everything that they do. But I am grateful for that experience because, good or bad, I needed it. You won't always like your coworkers, and it's the same with student teaching experiences. My second student teaching experience was in first grade, and it was a completely different experience than my first placement. I felt comfortable, welcome, and I had a lot of freedom with my teaching. I had a lot of fun in that placement, and I felt like I was able to really get a feel for my personal teaching style. I loved the time that I spent in that second placement. In both placements, I took a ton of photos, not of students, of course, and I took notes on everything. I asked questions all the time, no matter how silly it was, because I was there to learn, and if I didn't ask, I wouldn't know. So ask all the questions, no matter how ridiculous you feel. As far as observations go, I was a wreck before my first one, but as long as you plan and know the content that you're teaching, you will knock it out of the park. And then the more observations you do, the better you'll feel. One thing I did make sure to do was start teaching lessons and building those student-teacher relationships prior to my first observations so that I could know how to differentiate my lessons to adapt to the students' needs, and then they would also have trust in me and my observations would then be more natural and fluid. I remember after my first observation with the coordinator, the students asked, "How did you do? How did we do? Did you get an A?" It was so sweet. But if we didn't build those relationships prior to that observation, I don't think they would have cared, especially as fifth graders. So now I'm in internship two. Internship two is Monday through Friday, and it's 8 to 3:30. And then every other Friday, you have a mandatory capstone at the university. During capstone, you have to complete a teacher work sample, which is done throughout the semester and is 7 components. It is very detailed, but basically what you do for the teacher work sample is create a pre-assessment, then you give the students the pre-assessment, use the data from that pre-assessment to build a unit on that content, and then teach that content, give a post-assessment, use the data, analyze it, report on it. It's a big deal. At the end of this teacher work sample, some people had over 80 pages when it was all said and done. But it isn't as stressful as it seems when you learn about all the components and everything that goes into it when you're at capstone. A group of us rode up to university for that first capstone where we learned about the 7 components and all the details and everything that goes into it. And on the way back home, it was silent. It was like we were in shock from all the information that was just thrown at us. But it wasn't so bad once we got into it. But it also helped that we had each other to talk to and get through it together. That is one thing that I'll say that got me through this process. The group of friends that I made throughout my program, which are now my teacher besties. get yourself at least one person that you can confide in and help you through it that understands the program that you're in, because a lot of people aren't going to understand what you're going through, and it's really tough to do it on your own. My internship to placement ended up being in a fifth grade gifted class. I remember that I wasn't going to find out who I was with or what school I was at until a week prior to my internship starting. But in late December, I did get a text from my amazing mentor teacher, just welcoming me to the class, asking me if I had any questions and getting to know me before I even got to the school. He invited me to come meet with him before students came back from winter break, which made me feel even less nervous and more excited to get started. We met in his classroom, so I got to learn the layout and we just got acquainted, and it was just such a wonderful first meeting, and that is definitely not how my first semester went. And during that first meeting, I learned that he was the teacher of the year for the school and that he was a finalist for the teacher of the year for the school district. When I came to class that first day, the students had created a desk area for me and they said that it had to be aesthetically pleasing. So a couple of the girls went to Dollar Tree and bought a bunch of stuff, and just it was decorated so beautifully, and I could have cried, but that would have been weird because it was my first day. So I just took some pictures and moved on like it was no big deal, even though it was a big deal. By the way, he did end up winning the teacher of the year for the school district because he is just that amazing. And it was just announced a week or so ago that he is a finalist for the teacher of the year for the entire state of Florida. I won the mentor teacher lottery with this guy. I learned so much from him and his students. It was just the most amazing experience ever. In internship two, you have 3 observations with your UCF coordinator, and then you have 5 observations with your mentor teacher. Prior to my first observation, I again asked my teacher if I could start teaching a certain content area so I could start getting acquainted with the students, building those relationships, and feel more comfortable during those observations. I took notes on what worked, what didn't work, what I would like to improve on, and just overall what kind of things I would like to change in my teaching style. I've been told that I'm extremely reflective in my teaching, which I think could be a good thing or a bad thing depending on how I'm taking it. Sometimes I think I overanalyze things, and I also think that it just keeps me motivated to do better and keeps me wanting to help the students the best that I can, which is ultimately the goal. But being reflective and willing to learn is so important, and I do feel like it is one of my biggest strengths. I started taking over reading and then science, and then I started to add math, but then that is when the world shut down. My final student teaching experience was supposed to run from January to April. I believe April 24th was supposed to be my last day, but my last day of class was March 12th. And then the rest of my semester was digital, and I graduated virtually. It was such a sad ending to such an amazing semester. If I had to pick between having more time with those students and walking across the stage, hands down, I'd pick having more time with those students. I had such an amazing experience that I wanted to stay until the end of the school year, way past my internship. I still talked to my mentor teacher, and he told me that the students have been asking about me and asking if they can contact me even though my internship is over. And I know that's because of the relationships we've built and how connected we are. And I love them so much and I miss them. And I really wish the semester ended differently, but that's just not possible. It's just sad how everything ended, and I actually ended up missing my UK internship experience because it was planned in March, and that was canceled 2 days before everything went digital, so that's also a bummer. But yeah, that is my student teaching experience. Some tips for those who are going to be starting their student teaching experience: take pictures of everything, ask all the questions no matter how silly you feel, take every experience, good or bad, as a learning opportunity, build relationships with the students as well as your mentor teacher, jump into teaching as soon as possible, be reflective and willing to learn, and find a teacher friend in your program. You need to have that support. I want to thank you all for being here and supporting us on this journey. I hope you enjoyed, and if you did, please give it a real big thumbs up. That helps me pop up more in your feed, as well as it helps me reach others that might be interested in my videos as well. And if you have any questions or comments, please leave those below. And if you want to stick around, feel free to subscribe so you can join us on our adventures abroad, and I will see you in the next one.